the woman is a natural. She is perfection. Like, she was like, she was so phenomenal to work with. I was just like blown away by her.
Oh, wow.
What'd you think?
Congratulations on the film. No, I honestly loved it. I just spoke to Amel and Leigh-Anne, and I had to thank Amel for this opportunity to see UK Black culture represented in cinema in this Christmas movie. It meant so much to me, and I told him that I felt seen. So I wanted to ask you, how does it feel to be a part of this?
Oh, I mean, when I read this script, when I saw what Amel was striving to put together, I was so moved. I was so touched at his creation of this, because I didn't even realize that there had never been a Black British rom-com that centered us, our stories, and the way we perceive ourselves, we perceive our families, and just that, like, that life, that vivacity. And I was like, this is so incredible. And I thought he captured something singular and beautiful and important and necessary. And I was like, I have to be a part of this. And it gave me so much joy to just be in London during that season, during that time, and to be on that set with these phenomenal artists who really like brought me in. Like they like immediately treated me like I was family. And I was just like, this is amazing. Like, it felt so good to be there every day. Like, when I tell you, there were so many like just jokes and laughter and fun, and like we knew how important this would be for people. And so a lot of heart, a lot of love went into the making of this. And I think it comes across on screen. Like, you get that, like, oh, this is a real family. Like, you feel it.
One of the words that was just in my head when I was watching it was community. Like, I could tell there was just this essence of community on set. I didn't even have to ask you guys to know that there was, like, it was definitely there. But I heard you post about how many times you laughed, how hard you laughed on set. So what would you say what was the funniest moment?
Oh God, that's so hard, because we had so much fun. I'm gonna have to say the scenes in the house where I'm at the table playing dominoes with the uncles, like, they had me cracking up off screen. Like, we would just be like laughing like crazy. But there was, it's like, I don't want to give anything away, but I will just say, in one of those scenes where it's like me and Leigh-Anne across the table from each other and the uncles, and we're all playing dominoes, Amel did ask me to like just do a little ad-libbing. And at the end of one of those takes, like when he finally called cut, we all burst out laughing because he was like, I can't believe you said that. So that's all I'm gonna say though.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, that's jokes. That is so jokes. And I was gonna ask about you and Leigh-Anne. Obviously, you guys are both new mothers. Was that something that you got bonded over?
Like, so, I mean, we have talked since, you know, about like having our babies and stuff, because I was pregnant while we were filming, but I didn't tell anyone. Yes, I was.
So when Lisa was pregnant, like, yeah. Wow.
Yep, I was like, oh, it's like I've gone really method for this role. So, yes. So it was really great, like, after the fact, like, when I finally, like, came out about, like, my pregnancy, and Leigh-Anne totally wrote me, and we, like, kind of, like, oh, you know, we talked about our pregnancies and stuff. And yeah, just like getting to know her, getting to work with her. I could not believe that this was her first film, because the woman is a natural. She is perfection. Like, she was so phenomenal to work with. I was just like blown away by her. But actually, I'm like, it makes sense, because like, she's someone who's on stage and she's directed, and she just has an understanding of like what works, what doesn't. Like, it's innate in her. Like, so it was just really incredible to work with her, and we had such a good time.
You're going to London during the holidays.
Why did you say it's essential to promote this book?
It's the perfect opportunity for me to meet your family.
I don't even want to see my family.
Is this about Boxing Day, where your parents announced their divorce and you fled to America?
Snorting tea and crumpets, miserable most of the time.
Damn, Scrooge.
I like the scene where Leanne was singing Say a Little Prayer by Aretha Franklin. And that got me thinking, obviously, Jennifer Hudson played Aretha in this year in effect. So it got me thinking about biopics. So Aja, who would you want to play in a biopic? And I'm saying right now, Michelle Obama. Like, I'm just saying it. I have to say it.
Wow. Well, I mean, I would take that. I'm like, as a host, I would play Michelle Obama in a biopic.
Yes, you would.
Like, thank you. Like, that works for me. I feel like you answered your own question. Like, that goes. Like, yes, 1,000%. I'm here for it.
Would you say anyone else, or just we're sticking with Michelle?
I'm gonna stick with, I don't think anything can beat that right now.
I like that. Oh my God. Okay, next time I see him out, I'm gonna tell him, can we write that script for Aja?
Right, hello. Right. Yeah, ask him with that, please. Thank you.
Will do. And I loved in the film, I mean, you spoke about you getting down with young calls, but when the bit when Melvin was like kind of insulting your Jamaican accent, do you have any words against that? Because I liked your accent, okay?
I did.
I liked it. So let's, are we clapping back at Amel / Melvin?
Are we clapping back? I really thought that was one of the things I loved in the script when he was like, Lisa does a bad accent. I was like, I can nail a bad accent because I don't think I can do any kind of Jamaican myself. But I'm happy you liked it. I can't clap back. I ain't got nothing because I mean, just, yeah.
It was fun to watch. I'll give you that.
Thank you.
And essentially the whole film is about learning about Melvin's Christmas traditions. I've got to ask, what is your favorite Christmas tradition and what's one that you hate?
Ooh, my favorite Christmas tradition with my family, well, I'm like, the thing that me and my sisters used to do, me and my little sister used to pretend like we were Santa Claus for our youngest sister, even though she was a grown woman. We would like make it seem like, ooh, Santa's been here. Like, we would just like force her to leave out cookies and stuff, and we'd eat them overnight and be like, Santa showed up. And she'd be like, all right, y'all crazy, but sure. And that's, we would be very amused by this. But actually now I'm like, now that I have a child myself, I'm excited to start some new Christmas traditions with him once I figure out what those will be. maybe some more pretending to be Santa. And then, like, I don't think there's anything I hate about the holiday season. I'm just like, it's great. Time off of work, time with family. Like, yeah, it's my favorite time of the year, really.
Leigh-Anne said that she's not getting Christmas presents for her babies. She's like, no, they're not gonna remember. What do you think?
I'm definitely getting Christmas presents for my son. Like, I don't care if he can open it or not. I just want to take a bunch of pictures of him, like, holding on to a wrapped gift, and I'll probably let him drool on it or something before opening it for him. But yeah.
Just an empty box. Just take a picture of him.
Just an empty box.
Nothing in there.
And then
she also said one thing that she hates about Christmas traditions is that when people put up their decorations too early. So I thought you'd say something similar. Like, if people put it up too early, it's like, no. Like,
no such thing as too early. No such thing as keeping them too late.
If you
still have a tree in March, I'm here for it. It's like, I love all the twinkly things. Like, keep it up. It's pretty. Like, Christmas can be all year.
Good to know. Aja Naomi King says Christmas can be all year.